And welcome back to the vlog. It is 85 degrees in the house. It's 95 out. I am sweating up a storm right now. Really excited to get up to Alaska in 2 days. I'm headed up with a buddy, Ike Dooling. He's a guide based out of Haines, Alaska. And we're heading up further north, and I'm basically gonna go photograph like 20 days straight of Dall sheep hunting. Exciting stuff to come. And in this vlog, I'm just gonna run through all my camera gear, my backpacking gear, and my food that I will be bringing on this hunt. So let's dive in. First up is camera gear. So I'm bringing two camera bodies, the A7 R3, and then this camera that I'm filming on, the A7 S3. The A7 R3 is really amazing at photos, very high megapixels. It also does really good video. The A7 S3, the one that I'm filming on right here, has got a flip screen and is just really good at video. And I've got a lot of both photo and video deliverables for this photo assignment, and so that's why I'm bringing both. Both my cameras on the bottom, I've got a cotton carrier base plate with the universal mount. The universal mount, this piece right here, allows me to attach it to a tripod and also use the cotton carrier harness system. And the harness system allows me to carry the camera both on my chest or on my shoulder strap in my backpack instead of using a traditional neck strap. On the side of the camera right here, I've got a cotton carrier wrist strap, and then this strap, this is actually a Peak Design strap, and I'll throw this over my shoulder as well. Lenses I'm rocking, this one right here, this is probably my favorite lens of all time. It's also yielded the most used photos ever by brands and clients. This is the 7200 G Master f2.8. It's got image stabilization and the 200 zoom at f2.8. It just gives a really good background blur bokeh as well as lens compression. Absolutely love this lens. Don't go anywhere without it. Next lens is the 50mm f1.8. This tiny little lens, this thing, I don't know the exact specs, but it's super light. It's got a really low aperture. You just get some really unique shots and you can shoot in very low light with this thing. And it doesn't really weigh anything. This is gonna be a full-on backpack hunt, so anything I can do to cut weight is huge. This is my next lens. This is the Sony Macro. This is a 90mm f2.8. Macro just lets you get some really unique perspectives and get up close and personal with your subjects. It also doubles as kind of a zoom lens, being at 90, in case for some reason my 7200 broke, I could just throw this guy on and it would kind of give you that same look. The wide angle lens that I'm bringing is this one that I'm filming with right now. This is the Zeiss Betis 18mm f2.8. Normally I would bring a 16-35 f2.8, but my 16-35 is actually broke right now. All the photos that I've shot with it recently, they're all soft. There's something messed up with the glass. So what I'm bringing instead is this Zeiss Betis 18mm. My biggest zoom lens, if you may, is this Swarovski 30-70 power by 95mm objective. I shoot a lot of stuff through my spotter, mostly phone scope footage, and this thing gets just some absolutely insane shots. I use my iPhone to film wildlife through my spotting scope, and that's via this phone case right here. This is called a phone scope, and this piece just mounts right onto my spotting scope. You can also take this little adapter out and get one for your binoculars. So if you're bringing binos, you could just mount this right onto your binos and film through your binos. And over the years, I've been able to capture some pretty insane and really high quality footage of wildlife with this setup right here. Camera batteries are next. I usually plan on 1.5 to 2 batteries per day of shooting. So I'm bringing every single battery I own. It's 19 batteries. Next up is the RAV Power battery brick. I'm bringing 3 of these. This is the Extreme series. This one is rated at 26,000 megahertz amps. Basically, I can get about 7 iPhone charges with this. I'm bringing USB cords for my iPhone, also to power my Zolio, my satellite texting device, as well as a plug to charge my camera if necessary. This is a dual USB charger for my Sony batteries. I won't bring this in the field. I'll have this back at base camp or in the vehicle, in case we're at a hotel or something. Somewhere that has power, I can just charge two batteries at once. My cleaning kit, which consists of Zeiss alcohol cleaning wipes, as well as a little lens pen in there. This is a lens cloth. I'll have multiple of these. Usually have one in every pant pocket. It's important to keep your lens clean. This is an air blower. You squeeze it and it blows air out the front. If you get water droplets on your lens, you can simply squeeze it and it'll blow the water droplets right off. Also great for getting just dust and debris off. When it's really wet and humid out, if you use a lens cloth or toilet paper or anything, it's kind of just gonna smear the water. But this, when you just squeeze it and blow the water droplets off, they do not smear. One lithium-ion AAA battery. This will go in my Sennheiser MKE400 mic that I've got mounted on this camera that I will also be bringing. The Sennheiser MKE mic, the battery lasts with one of these lithiums like 100 hours, so I probably won't need to replace this. But in case I forget to turn the mic off a few nights in a row, I'll have a spare to get me through this whole 20-day stint. I'm traveling via air, and before I go, I'm gonna take little like half-inch pieces of masking tape and cover all the battery terminals of my Sony batteries. Sometimes airlines freak out when you have this big, massive bundle of batteries, and so to prevent them from potentially sparking, not that they ever would, but if they did, you can put this tape over the little terminals, and it should prevent them from sparking. So, little safety precaution there. This right here, this is a lens coat. It's just basically a neoprene waterproof cover that goes over my camera and allows me to shoot in inclement weather and keeps my lens and my camera dry. Cotton carrier Scout. This will mount on my chest and allows me to carry my camera on my chest instead of using a traditional neck strap. All of that camera gear is gonna go into this Pelican case right here. This is a Pelican Air 1535. It's meant for air travel. It's the biggest carry-on size that they allow. They've also like pared it down to make it as light as possible. I'll be putting TSA locks on that Pelican case as well as all of my luggage. Next up is food. So I'm gonna be shooting for 3,200 calories per day, and that's gonna consist of Gastronome meals, Honey Stinger performance chews, Nature Valley crunch bars, Pro Bar meals, Cliff Shot energy gels, Honey Stinger protein bars, oatmeal, Honey Stinger waffles, and Black Rifle instant coffee. Where we are going in Alaska, we are required to put all of our food in these Kevlar, basically bear-proof sacks. And so this one is from UR Sack. I've actually got two of these. Opens up pretty big, but between two of these, I'll be able to fit all of my food in. These things cost like $100. They're pretty dang expensive and they weigh maybe 5 ounces per. So definitely heavier than your normal stuff sack. A lot burlier too, obviously. There's a weight consequence here, but again, we're required to have them where we're going. I'll bring one camp mug. This is a titanium Vargo mug. It's a Bot 700 is the model. This thing weighs, I think, 4 ounces. Titanium spork for eating freeze dreads. This one is a long version. Most normal ones would go to about here. This one is about 3 inches longer. Pretty epic when you're digging into your freeze-dried bags because you don't get your hand covered in freeze-dried. A long spork is a must-have. For carrying water, I've got this 2-liter platypus. The beauty of these things is when there's no water in them, when they're empty, they're tiny. There's like hardly any weight or space consequence. I'm also bringing this 1.5-liter Nalgene. It's just great to have a Nalgene, just because they're super burly, you really can't break them. Next up is some of my camping gear and other kind of essentials. So I'll bring one trekking pole. This is from Sissy Sticks. I wrap duct tape and Gorilla Tape around this pole. You never know when you're gonna need tape. This right here is basically a stuff sack from Hyperlite. That you unzip it, and on the inside, this really nice soft fuzzy fabric, and basically what you do with this, you use it as a pillow. So every night before I go to bed, I will stuff whatever unused clothing I'm not wearing to bed into this, and it'll make a really nice and soft pillow. The tent I will be using on this hunt is the Hilberg Enon. It's a one-person, three-season tent. This thing is really burly. Weighs about 3 pounds. I've used this tent all over the planet. Definitely my go-to for packing light. Condensation inside tents can get really bad. Doesn't really matter which tent you have. Whether it's a single wall, double wall, you always get condensation. So I bring a little sponge. This is just like a dish sponge that you would buy at the grocery store. I cut it in half. And so every morning when I wake up, if there's condensation on the inside of the tent, I'll wipe it down and then I'll just squeeze it out outside the tent. And it's amazing. I mean, on a 10-day hunt, like the amount of water accumulation that will develop on the inside of the tent is pretty significant, and you can really combat that and stay significantly more dry if you use a sponge. My sleeping pad is the Thermarest NeoAir. It's got a really high R value, which is like a heat retention value, and it only weighs 16 ounces. This is the Sika Gear Kelvin Aerolite 30 sleeping bag inside a Granite Gear compression sack. Here's my emergency kit. I did a previous vlog on everything that I keep inside this emergency kit. One new thing that I just added is a cat tourniquet. I also changed up the bag to this. This is like a med kit bag. It's just fits everything I need into it, and it's got a clear window so I can see everything. This is my toiletry kit that I will take on the hunt. I've got everything from toothpaste to ibuprofen to ginger chews to antiseptic wipes to eye drops, toothbrush, toothpaste, obviously, floss, and cold medicine. This is a headlamp I'm running. I can't tell you a whole lot about it other than it's really similar to the Phoenix HL60R, but better. I can't fly with bear spray, but when I get to Alaska, I'm gonna buy some bear spray. We're going into a super berry zone, so this is a must. A couple other unique pieces. These are Wiggy Waders. You throw these on top of everything you're wearing. They weigh about 7 ounces and they allow you to cross rivers and creeks without taking your boots off. It's probably gonna be mosquito heaven up in Alaska, so this is a mosquito head net. I don't bring bug spray because if you bring bug spray, you're probably gonna use it all in the first day. So instead, I just choose to cover up and use a head net. I am bringing a tripod. This is the Tsurui T024X tripod. This is an older version. They make a newer one now, but this thing, it's a 1, 2, 3, 4 section tripod, weighs about 2 pounds, super light. I spray painted this to get that kind of black, shiny sheen off of it in case an animal sees it, doesn't spook it. And I almost forgot, I am bringing ND and circular polarizing filters for all of my lenses. The ND filter simply controls the amount of light in or out. And this is amazing for video because it allows me to keep shutter speed that's double my frame rate and allows you to shoot at lower apertures, giving you a more cinematic look. And then polarizers do exactly what polarized sunglasses do. Allow you to see into water really well and also just add more color and contrast to the skies. The backpack I'm running is the Marshall. This is a 6,500 cubic inch pack on the Mystery Ranch guide light frame. I've got a waist belt pocket on the side for my headlamp. And then right here, I got my bear spray holster. Up here, I've got the cotton carrier strap shot. This allows me to carry my camera on my shoulder instead of around my neck via neck strap. And all the gear I just ran through is somehow going to fit into this backpack. But before it all goes into here, it's gonna go into 2 Sika Drifter duffels, and it's gonna fly north to Haines, Alaska, which is where the real adventure is gonna start. Whew, all right. So in a previous vlog, I actually went through my full Sika layering system. So I'm not gonna include that in this one, but I will link that above. And if you wanna see a full list of every single piece of gear that I'm bringing in, I have that on my website, blog, and I will link that in the description below. But that's a wrap on this vlog. Hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please hit the like button. If you wanna see more, hit subscribe. I say it all the time, but seriously, doing both helps me out a ton. The next vlog will be me traveling north to Haines, Alaska.